Hey guys, what's up? So the next poem I'll be reading is poem 1388, and this is called The Power of Femininity. I think it's so important to acknowledge powerful women today, or women who inspire us in any way possible, from music to movies to politics, fashion, good deeds, or making a difference in the world, or maybe just being a mother, an aunt, a grandmother, a sister, or a best girlfriend. The Power of Femininity. I dedicate this poem to all the beautiful, inspiring, powerful women around the world and those who have inspired me in my life. It's nighttime, my bedroom door closed, lamp on where the nightstand is, all cozy in my bed, comfortably. To be honest, I'm feeling curious. I grab my phone and go to the Face app near the YouTube. I pose and snap a selfie and hit where it says gender change. And within seconds, there I am, the opposite sex. I slightly chuckle as I tilt my head. You know, I would make a pretty woman. I wonder. I go into the bathroom, hit the switch, and look into the mirror, scratch my beard and grab the razor, let the water run from the faucet, grabbing the shaving cream, applying it to my face, and then looking at my hairy legs. Here we go. Anne Frank, Queen Elizabeth, Virginia Woolf, Lucille Ball, Coco Chanel, Meryl Streep, Eartha Kitt, Jane Austen, Hillary Clinton, Marilyn Monroe, Diana Ross, Emily Dickinson, Angelina Jolie, Whitney Houston, Elizabeth Taylor, Gloria Estefan, Princess Diana, Betty Davis, Rosa Parks, Ellen DeGeneres, Jennifer Lopez, Sandra Bullock, Lady Gaga, Adele, Halle Berry. I grab the liquid foundation and apply it on my face, and then use the powder until the blemishes are gone. I now have a blank canvas. I look back at all the colors and pull out a red lipstick. Mother Teresa, Cher, Viola Davis, Rita Hayworth, Nicole Kidman, Anna Wintour, Jenna Jackson, Margaret Thatcher, Maya Angelou, Selena Quintanilla, Tina Turner, Salma Hayek, Goldie Hawn, Tyra Banks, Julia Roberts, Dorothy Dandridge, Barbara Streisand, Cindy Crawford, Angela Bassett, Celine Dion, Glenn Close, Michelle Obama. After the makeup and the lashes, I gently applied the wig, blow drying with the hair dryer. As the long strands flow, I use the comb to straighten, style, and position. The first gathering devoted to women's rights in the United States was held July 19, 1848 in New York. Adjusting the bra, filling them in while laughing, then spraying the perfume glow on my neck, looking at the dress on the hanger and what heels to go with it. A makeup artist for celebrities joining the Olympics, a bodybuilder, a construction worker, all different, but doing their thing, running for president, a single mother juggling two jobs with four kids, a singer, a pilot, a police officer, a firewoman, the mayor, a chef in Congress, an artist, an actor, a teacher, managing a company, and battling breast cancer. Opening the front door, walking out with my head up high, purse on my shoulder, shades on, strutting myself as heads turn, mouths drop, wondering what on earth am I doing, liberating myself, feeling the power of femininity. I snapped out of the glimpse and looked back at the photo and shut my phone off. Whatever a man can do, a woman can do too. As you can see, all of these lovely ladies and much more have proved that.